Hello, how you doing? My name is Jovan and we are back with another video. Today, we'll be reviewing the diet of a man who does everything. He's a doctor, he's an astronaut, he's a teacher, aka Johnny Sins. All I can tell is his diet is mostly for maintenance. Not losing, not gaining, but just to maintain that look so he'll always look that good in his upcoming scenes. If he's bulking, then he's gonna get fatter, meaning he's not gonna look good. And if he's cutting, then he's gonna look dry as hell. Like, let's say if he's on 8 or 10% body fat, like literally dry as hell. I just wanna say this, so let's say if you're trying to clap cheeks when you're on 8 or 10% body fat, you're not gonna survive. Because you have low testosterone, you feel nauseous as hell, you feel dry as fuck, and you just can't focus for shit. So let's say Johnny Sins, he goes up doing a scene, and literally after 10 pumps, he's gone, on the floor, fainted. Yeah, you like that, don't you, you filthy fucking, oh my, I don't feel. Yo, I think he's dead. And it's still hard. Okie dokie, so without further ado, roll the clip.
Spinach, chocolate almond milk, banana, whey protein, peanut butter, oats.
So far it actually looks pretty good, but I don't like how he used peanut butter and almond milk. So yeah, with peanut butter, I would highly recommend switching that with PB2 powdered peanut butter. Has 95% less fat, way less calories, and it still has the same amount of protein. And with the almond milk, he did not use the unsweetened almond milk, so I would highly recommend getting the unsweetened almond milk. So it has way less calories.
All right, time for my after gym smoothie. I use this whey for after my workout because it's got glutamine and BCAAs in it.
I'm stopping at this one because I just want to say the anabolic window is bullshit. You're not gonna like simply lose your gains because you're not taking your protein within 30 minutes after your workout. So just don't think too much about it.
All right, got my breakfast, little scrambled eggs and spinach, and of course my chocolate milk oatmeal concoction.
Again, so far it looks pretty good, looks delicious and healthy. But with the almond milk, like I said before, I would switch that with unsweetened almond milk because it's lower in calories. And with the eggs, he's using whole eggs, so if you want to switch to a lower calorie version, then switch that to like full egg whites. Like for example, 100 milliliters of egg whites has only 53 calories and has probably around 10 or 12 grams of protein. Now the thing is, like, the egg yolk on its own is really, really high in calories.
Tortilla, hummus, super greens, avocado, chicken. All right, I think that's it. First things first, cook our tortilla. I don't really know the best way to cook our tortilla. I just put it on medium heat and kind of move it around. All right. Oof. Take about 1 tablespoon of hummus. Spread it around. Next, I do the greens. We cheat a little bit. We buy the shredded chicken from the Whole Foods salad bar, and it's really great. It's not too expensive, and it's already cut up, ready to go. It's already cooked. Takes no time to prep, so it's awesome. Well, not the prettiest looking wrap today, but it's a wrap.
It actually looks so good. Like, it looks so crispy. I actually want some. But, like, I'm gonna be real. I don't like this one because of two things. Because of the avocado and the hummus. The rest are fine, but two of those, I don't like them because they're really, really high in calories. So, with hummus, bruh, I've seen what they make using that. I've seen the videos. They use a lot of olive oil in making that, meaning it's literally high in fats, high in calories. And with avocado, it's also high in calories. The thing is, fat in any source from animal, from plants, they're still high in calories, meaning they will not help you with your fat loss. So for sauce replacements, I would highly recommend switching that with 99% fat-free mayonnaise and sriracha. For avocado, I don't know, like, I just don't know what's a good replacement. Probably tomato, paprika, and other vegetables that doesn't have any fats.
Coconut oil spray. So lately what I've been doing is going to Whole Foods on the salad bar and getting their shredded chicken breast, quinoa veggie mix, edamame, carrot shreds, broccoli shreds, corn, all kinds of shreds of vegetables in there, which I really love. And I don't eat it as a salad. I don't really like to eat cold things, so.
I love how you use the oil spray, because one spray, not a lot of oil, but it will cover the whole pan. Sauteing your salad for that salad version, I might try it. But in terms of the salad that he has in the video, it looks really good, it looks really healthy, and not a lot of sauce, meaning it's low in calories and high in volume. But if you want to be safer, then I would recommend making your own salad so you can weigh them on the scale and then you can calculate the calories. So that is pretty much it for his diet, and I will rate that diet a 7 out of 10. Not super healthy, not junky, but it's like fairly healthy. But if you use my recommendation, you can have more of them because they're lower in calories, higher in volume, meaning you can feel full longer. That's pretty much it for the video. So if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.